SsangYong vehicles have long been renowned for their towing ability. With over 60 years of experience of making 4x4 vehicles, and with its roots in rugged military vehicles, the current range has the best towing ability ever, with the Rexton and Musso able to tow up to 3,500 kilograms to match the best in their respective classes. Before you begin towing, it's essential that you check your vehicle can handle the trailer. Vehicle towing capacities are there for a very good reason and should not be exceeded. You want to check the gross trailer weight, which is the trailer plus the load, against the maximum towing capacity of your vehicle. You should also make sure that the engine of your vehicle is up to the challenge of carrying an extra load, in particular when it comes to tricky or hilly terrain. To guarantee the safety of yourself and other road users, you have to ensure that the load does not extend beyond the trailer. This is both dangerous and illegal. Right, now you're nearly ready. It's time to load up. Now, when loading your trailer, try and distribute the weight as evenly as possible. And just remember that overloading can have a serious effect on the stability of the trailer. Now, one good rule of thumb is to ensure that whatever load you're carrying, the heaviest part of it is towards the front end of the trailer, so that the rear axle of the towing vehicle can manage some of that load. So if you're towing a car and it's front engine, drive it forwards onto the trailer. If it's a rear engine car, reverse it onto the trailer. One final thing is to check that any loads you are carrying are seriously fastened. An unsecured load can slide around and result in a loss of stability, or even shoot forwards when you go down a hill or apply the brakes. Now, no matter the vehicle, towing a load behind it is inevitably going to alter its performance. Stopping distances are going to be increased, cornering will become cumbersome, and manoeuvres are going to require time and a lot of patience and planning. Today, we're going to cover some basic steps in familiarising yourself with how your SsangYong will behave when towing a load. You never know when it's going to come in handy, because these vehicles are made for towing. They're fantastic. One of the hidden dangers that's often overlooked is environmental factors. Now, things like crosswinds can have a massive effect on the vehicle and its load. They are actually your worst enemy. So I'd advise you to pay close attention to the weather forecast. And if it's going to be a very windy day, then put off the towing job until another day. So now we're finally out and about towing. It's taken a fair bit of prep to get out of here, and the open road now lies before you and your adventure awaits. Now, national speed limits apply in the UK, but on motorways, towing vehicles are limited to 60 miles per hour, and they're not allowed to use the right-hand lane. Now, let's talk about braking, because you want to avoid braking sharply whenever you can. Make sure that you have plenty of time to be able to react to the environment around you. Now, sharp braking can result in what's known as jackknifing, where the trailer is going faster or trying to go faster than the vehicle that's towing it, and therefore pushes the rear of the vehicle around and closes it like a jackknife. Now, make sure that you reduce your speed before you corner. I'm just coming off here. I've got a sharp bend going round to the left now. So I'm making sure that I'm going at the speed that I want to be in when I'm actually taking the corner, before I actually hit the corner itself. Now, you may have heard of snaking. Now, this is when the trailer and its load start to go out of line with the towing vehicle and start to snake from side to side, like the tail wagging the dog. You need to know how to be able to mitigate that circumstance to try and prevent loss of control of the trailer and its load and the vehicle that you're driving as well. So what happens if we find ourselves in a snaking situation? Well, change down a gear and take both of your feet off the pedals to start with. If you're going downhill, try a little bit of light braking, but do not panic and try and brake heavily. It may get you into more trouble. Do not try and accelerate or steer out of a snaking situation, because again, you could find yourself in even deeper water than you were in the first place, and find yourself very quickly turning it into a jackknife or an overturning situation. We all know that reversing can be difficult when towing, but don't worry, by the end of this video, we'll have you doing it like a pro. So first of all, straight and narrow. make sure that your vehicle and trailer are in a nice straight line, and also ensure that you've got enough room to maneuver around you. Now, we're okay, on to the next thing. Keep the angle shallow. You want to ensure that the angle between the towing vehicle and the trailer are as shallow as possible. You don't want tight, acute angles. If you get into a bit of a fix with your trailer at 90 degrees to the car, then you're going to be in trouble and you're going to have to start again. Thirdly, turn the opposite way. When looking in the rear view or side mirrors, remember that the more of the trailer that you can see, the more that you need to turn your vehicle in the opposite way to correct this. Now remember that mirrors are your friends. That's the fourth thing. You may find yourself having to reverse around corners. So when you do, use your mirrors to ensure that your trailer's not ending up at too acute an angle so that you get into a jackknife situation. There we are. Thank you for following my reversing tips, and I hope that they've been useful. And remember, take your time, and you're in safe, capable hands in a Sanyo.